Would you now please locate the settlement of Tiahuanaco in the Bolivarian Andes near the shores of Lake Titicaca?
Yes, we have the place.
Then would you please locate the port of Puma Punku, I guess, which is nearby?
Yes, we have this place.
Here there are finely cut stones weighing between 100 to 500 tons, quarried and transported from 10 miles away. Were the same levitation technique used to build the pyramids used to move these stone blocks?
We see they are smooth and would indicate that they were used to rub against one another. As we examine, we can find that there would be something of the application or the disruptor here placed on top of the block. We would agree that there would be similar ability to float the stone, you'll say, direction.
What people or civilization built this place?
These would be those who would immigrate from the Atlantean locations in which they would move out into the world, where there was great migration, usually thought of as east, but it was also here, northeast, east, southeast, some south and some southwest to west from this great location, you'll say. This would be the emanations or the beginnings of these technologies being spread through the world, you'll say. This would be about the 10th as to thousands of years in which they would have been utilized, but here this would be closer to the 5,500th year in which this would spread out into the world, you'll say, from this point in time direction.
What tools or equipment were used to carve out the stones and move them? And
there would be a method of what you would similar understand as concentration of light and sound. That you would see now as to light concentrated into laser, and that it would be concentrated into sound, so there would be somewhat of a cutting or melting of the same. The residual vibration can be duplicated by taking one rock and smashing it or banging it on another rock, causing a groove to appear. But in ancient times, it was a matter of cutting the rock by heating it up and causing the concentration of sound or frequency of sound to blow away or discard the heated up segments of the rock. Understand it would be like lava as it would be heated, and then it would be like a giant fan or a conduit with air blasting away the melted portions. Understanding, of course, it was not air, otherwise it would have cooled and hardened, defeating the purpose. But with somewhat sonic or vibrational rates that are even used in toothbrushes, you can see how the unwanted matter was dislodged, you'll say. We are speaking in, of course, simplistic terms. Direction.
Astronomical alignment of a nearby temple places its construction around 15,000 BC. Is this accurate?
As we would examine this, we would find that this would be one building on top of another. The newer one would be somewhat sooner than the time you are sending us to, you'll say, direction.
It is theorized by some that this place was an Atlantean port. Is this accurate?
We have indicated this, yes, to the question.
And why was it abandoned?
There were huge swells of water. There was movement of land masses. And there was warfare between those who would be the ruling families in this location. These would be the rules of thumb as to why the place disintegrated or diminished in population and then was abandoned here. But at the last, it would largely be due to the movements of water, inundation of water, or ocean, as you would call it, direction.